My name is Inna-Pirjetta Lahti and I come from Finland. I'm the leader of Nordic Bloggers Experience and I have my own company Innastus, who is designing events and experiences for bloggers and industries working with bloggers.
What is Ping Ethics?
We have just launched Ping Ethics, the ethical code for all content providers and companies working with content providers. So it's a code which makes content marketing more transparent and more honest and more trustable for all our followers.
There are other codes of ethic out there for pro bloggers and Instagrammers and so on. So what makes this different, and is it just unique to Finland?
No, it's not just unique to Finland, but as we all know, in Nordics, it's very important to be very honest. And it's very natural that this code is now coming from Finland. We have designed this code together with the participants and partners of Ping Helsinki event, which is gathering content creators for all different channels, YouTubers, Snapchatters, Instagrammers, bloggers, and also from all different branches. And I think that's the biggest difference to the codes that I have seen. Those are maybe codes for fashion bloggers, codes for lifestyle bloggers, codes for travel bloggers. But this code is open for everybody working with content marketing.
I think what's clever about it is that where codes, and I've myself been involved in writing a blogger's code of ethics, but that's a document, and this isn't just a document, is it? It's actually it's a set of questions, because you have two parties involved here, and you've got two sets of questions. Explain how that is on the website.
Yeah, so you go to the website and you choose, are you a content guru, meaning that you are a content provider, YouTuber, Instagrammer, Snapchatter, or blogger, or whatever in the future it's going to be your channel. And then you go to the list of questions and you have to tick the box that you agree with those things, like that you value your own work, or you are professional when you are doing the cooperation, or that you are telling your followers that this is a cooperation post, which is really important thing to keep the trust of your followers.
To be transparent.
Exactly.
And also the questions about the way that you work professionally. For example, one of the tick boxes I notice is, I will diligently check all the copyrights and make sure that I have the right to, for these images or whatever it might be.
Yeah, and also that you are aware of the other competitors of your client, because sometimes that's also challenging. For example, travel bloggers are working with various hotel brands simultaneously, so it's important to be open that, okay, I'm doing this now, but next week I will do something else with some other hotel brand. And then if you are an advertiser or marketer, then you are called business hippie, which means that you are working with the content creators. And mostly we are talking here about independent content providers who are also publishers. Of course, we have in the world, we have many content marketing professionals who are not independent, who are working for a media, for example. But this code will help. You can sign it even if you're working for a media, but this is more thought for the independent content creators. So business hippie will do the same thing, go there, sign it, and then when you're contacting the potential partners, you can tell that I'm transparent, I'm honest, and I will value your work.
All those things are actually laid out because you, as you say, you've gone through, it's quite a lot of questions, 18 questions or thereabouts, and you get down to the bottom and you tick the thing, you sign it. So then you're kind of in the system, you're logged. So in a sense, there's also a kind of a marketing process to this as well, because it means that everybody else who can see the Ping Ethics code can see who has signed up to it. So if you're a business, you could look specifically for content creators who have signed the Ping Ethics. Is that the thinking behind it?
Yes, that's the thinking behind it. And also when you have signed it, you will get access to the logo. So you can add the logo to your media kit or you do your website. And of course, in the future, we will probably do it somehow that you have like English speaking blogs or content creators and Finnish and other languages. Like now it's only one list, but this is just the beginning and we are open for all kind of cooperation possibilities. And if there is something similar going on somewhere in the world, please contact us. We are happy to cooperate with you.